when you're using the Schoology conference tool, just be mindful, stay classy, do the right thing at the right time. And if you're not sure what that right thing is, you can ask your teacher. Remember to follow the student handbook conduct rules for your school, for that's language appropriateness, images appropriateness. Be mindful that you do not have to turn on your web camera and that what images or what one would see if the web camera was on. So be mindful of that. I would recommend you don't turn on your web camera when you're interacting with the Schoology Conferences tool for the live instruction from your teachers. You will be able to participate with your microphone on your device. A couple other things is teachers will be able to record everything that goes on in the live conferences. They'll be able to document it. They'll be able to save whatever's typed in it. So also be mindful of what you're saying, what you're typing, the language that you're using. Just make sure it's appropriate for school and it's on topic. And then let me show you how to use Schoology Conferences as a student. As a student, when I'm in the course, I'll click on Conferences here on the left side. You might get this button right here, just your first time to allow it. And then I'll be able to see what conferences are being scheduled, what time. They won't show up for me to actually click on to participate until the teacher starts them. I can also see completed ones as a student, and I can play those videos as well that is in the conference app. Once they're here, they're going to see what are the conferences being scheduled. They'll see the whole weekly schedule if a teacher had laid that out. They won't be able to join anything until the teacher starts them, so that at least the student knows the date and time that they're going to begin. When the student comes to conferences and it's in session that the teacher has started it, this is what the student will see. And they can see that it's in progress and they can click this link right here and they'll be able to join it. The student is also going to get the test to use their microphone or listen. And those could be, the student can click the microphone or just listen only. But let's say they're going to participate. They can click the microphone. They're going to get the allow each time they use conferences. They'll click allow, and they're going to get a test as well. So then they'll do the test, and if they can hear themselves, they'll say yes. And then they're in it. Students click share notes, and they'll see those same notes there, and then they can also collaborate as well. Then students, they can click on the public chat, and they can also type. Now, a teacher can see what they have done, and it is recorded in here. A couple other tools they have in this video conference, there at the bottom is the microphone. You can click that to mute or unmute yourself, but just be mindful that on the left-hand side, you'll see your name, and if it shows the red microphone, that means the teacher is controlling the mics of the students and can mute them or unmute them at any time or give those permissions. Also at the very bottom is your button that you can turn on or off your webcam. Again, I would advise keeping the webcam off, but just participate through the public chats, the shared notes, annotating when the teacher turns it on the slide decks, or you can even when the teacher unmutes you and asks you to share out, then you can participate, but keep the webcam off. You will have annotation tools when the teacher allows it on the right-hand side. So you'll be able to draw, write, type, you can change the color and thickness, you can even do undo. Also, your teacher will be sharing out slide decks that you can annotate on. The teacher will turn that on when you have those annotation tools. They can send out polls that you'll interact. They'll pop up on your screen. You just chime in. Also, you can download any of the PowerPoints that the teacher is sharing out if they allow it. One other thing is teachers can push out YouTube videos to you. The teacher controls the play of these videos, the pause of them. They will play or pause in real time on your side to watch them, but just know the teacher has control of that. Also, be mindful in the top is the red button. If you see that, that means that this is being recorded as a video file. The teacher has turned that feature on. When the meeting ends, you'll be able to give feedback Also, you can come back to your Schoology course to find links that your teacher put up or the conferences button to watch the conference and review it again.